Welcome to this presentation, which is called Estimating Absorption of Materials to Match Room Model Against Existing Room Using a Genetic Algorithm. It's a presentation I made first time at Forum Acusticum in Krakow 2014, and it's by myself, Klaus Lünge, my two colleagues, George Kutzeris and Jens Holger Rindl. It highlights a feature which we have implemented in ODEON 13, which helps you to match the materials in a model of a real room so it matches well against reality. The agenda of the presentation is problem to be solved, genetic algorithms in short, search space, fitness function, case study, which is a small auditorium, and then finally conclusions. So what is the problem to be solved? Well, when you have renovation projects, you create a room acoustic simulation model which you want to match against the reality. What you do know is the situation in the current room. You know room acoustic parameters from measurements in a number of source and receiver positions. What is unknown, or imprecise at least, is materials in terms of absorption coefficients. So we wish to estimate these materials. So, the genetic algorithms. What is this all about? Genetic algorithm is, as suggested by the name, inspired by genetics. So what you do is you have a number of individuals, which in our case is the combination of absorption materials at a given octave band. And you have this combination which mimics all the materials in the room. Then you test by simulation how well each of these candidates behave, these candidate solutions, how close do we come to the target of reality. Then, having tested these candidates, we take the best one of those, maybe 50% or so, and then we recombine these good solutions, while at the same time we use genetic operators as mutation and inversion, and then again and again we test by simulation how good are the candidates, take the best candidates and recombine and so on. This takes many iterations, and therefore the calculations you use must be fairly fast. Here we have a flowchart over the genetic process. So we have our different candidate materials. We also have a search range saying how much are the absorption coefficients allowed to change. For example, if it's a fairly hard material, you might want it to change between 1 and 10% of absorption, and so on. And then we have different selections of material which are within our search range, where it's just first for the first run random selections. Then you run your genetic algorithm, you test how good are the materials in your simulator, and then you take the best ones of them and you run again your genetic evolution. The target we are using in our setup as implemented in ODEON is that we make use of room acoustics parameters measured in a number of receiver positions. So in this case we'll use 10 source receiver positions, and then we'll use some room acoustics parameters for those point responses. We're not trying in any way to match the complete impulse response, because we know that measurements are not perfect and simulations are not perfect. So instead what we try to do is we try to say, well, we should mimic good the acoustic parameters which we know are important, so they will be used as our target function. So the fitness function looked like this. What we could test is EDT, for example, T30, gravity time, the G parameter, strength, clarity 50, clarity 80. In this case, six parameters. And then we want to test over a number of source receiver positions in order to get the spatial variation in the room correct. So not only we want a global average of, say, clarity or reverberation to be right, but we also want to mimic correctly the position of the measured parameters. And that is to say that it's not without importance where the absorption is situated in the room, whether it's on all surfaces, or for example you have absorption on a back wall and a front wall or whatever. Our fitness function is taken by making an average deviation of each of the parameter normalized by the just noticeable difference, so we can combine together different parameters like clarity and reverberation time and gravity time and so on, because we normalize with just noticeable difference, which for clarity, for example, is 1 dB, and for reverberation time it's 5% of the relative difference. So here is the error function, and that should be as small as possible. Here you see the JNDs for different parameters, and what I show here is the room acoustics parameter list in ODEON, where you can decide which parameters should be visible. And therefore we only check some of the parameters, like in this case EDT, T30, gravity time, SPL, which is comparable to G, and C50 and 80. So you can decide what parameter you want to put in your fitness function. Then we have a question of limiting the search space. And the search space is saying that... I'll just start the video so you can see what happens. That how much do we allow each of the materials in the room to vary. So you can see here we open the search space by making it bigger and bigger in percentage. By default they are 50%, which is not a bad suggestion really. Again, you can see how we can change it for different types of material. It's important to say that there is a certain limit to how much we allow materials to change. Otherwise you might end up with mineral wool on the floor and nice wooden floor on the ceiling, and that's not what we want. So we want to tell as much as we know, but on the other hand the algorithm should be allowed to change reasonably within the limits where we are not certain what is the correct answer. So this was selecting search space. The case study we have here is a small auditorium, and we have 10 source receiver pairs, we have 2 source positions, 5 receivers. Then we had our initial materials. I'll not go more into what the different absorption coefficients are, but that's what we said. This must be it. And you just select your materials and assign to different surfaces. And then you have, by doing this, in this case I think 11 different groups of materials which can be varied within some search range. You can see here how the fitness function decreases, so you get better and better fitness when you run these generations of testing different absorption data. Each generation is a number of individuals. You typically use 2 times the number of materials, so in this case 22 individuals per generation, and one individual is then 10 point response calculations in terms of calculation effort. Here we see how we were able to decrease the error. The red bars are before we started the optimization, and after we have the green bars, which are from 500 and upwards in frequency, well, just 1 DND or less. At low frequencies we get less fitness, and that is to say that we have modes in these low frequencies. It doesn't really mean that on average reverberation time is not matching well. It is, but it means that the position variation of different parameters can't be met by an energy-based model like ODEON. So it's only on average that you get a nice agreement in reverberation time, for example. For higher frequencies we even match with position quite nicely. Here we did the same with 50% search range, I think. Another, yeah, less variation on the materials. Here you see how EDT before matching, before the optimization process and after the optimization process, we can see that we have very nice agreement between measured and simulated results. And if you look here at receiver 2, we see also with respect to frequency, the agreement is very nice. We can do the same for T30. Here we have looked at lower frequencies, and again you can see we have very nice agreement at 250 Hz. If we go to gravity time again, this is not an issue to match well. It's at 1000 Hz here. Clarity at 1000 Hz. We also have an improvement. It's not at 1000 Hz, it's the wrong title. It's actually at 125 Hz. And that makes my point for saying that we're not able to match each position very well. Here we have receiver 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can see that there are deviations for some of the positions, but on average the clarity is actually matched quite well. And when we look over here, it's in higher frequencies, it matches well. From 500 and up, it's very nice agreement. At low frequencies, we have bigger deviations as expected. But that's only on the individual positions. On the average for this call, the agreement is nice. A small interesting thing, I think, is that at this wall, we were not sure of what was. It's a kind of resonating back wall in the hall, and we didn't know exactly what is the resonance frequency of this wall. We know that it's not working well in the existing room. It wasn't wrongly designed, obviously. So we started out just putting it at 0.3 for coefficients, all octaves. And then after searching, we end with this optimum solution, where we have high absorption at 125 and 250 Hz. And we consistently end at that result if we rerun the calibration procedure with different transients. So it can do that. I'll just have a small demonstration of the material optimizer, and it has just been released as we speak. So here we look into our model of the room. We have a wireframe and so on, and we start our calibration process. I would just give some bigger search range for all materials, and this is just to show you with 100% search range the variation. It's bigger, it's easier to see the variation and what the algorithm does at this. I'm running at 40 times speed in this video just to help you see what's going on. You can see this display, it shows the errors of the different generations, and you can see that we actually convergate. Keeps on coming with some heavy spikes because that's how the genetic algorithm works. It tries different solutions and introduce some randomness in order not to get stuck in a wrong solution in a local minima. And you can see that it keeps on optimizing for some time, and not only the first generation or second generation, but we have better and better solutions. And now we reach to a point where it doesn't really get any better. This is the optimum coefficients we found so far, and these are the different individuals being tested currently. And you can see over here that we have quite some improvements of results. From 500 and up, we are at just one noticeable difference. I tested this with 100% search range, as I said, to make it fast, to make you see the changes that comes. Not because it's a realistic way of doing things. So the conclusions here are that we have built a material optimization for the ODEON Room Acoustics software. It's based on genetic algorithms. It's easy to specify a search range, and it's important to limit the variations of materials so you don't get awkward materials at awkward positions in the room. The fitness function takes into account multiple room acoustic parameters and multiple source receiver positions, so we are able also to simulate spatial variation in the room and get that right, which is important. We can reduce the deviation between measured and measurements and simulations, and error is reduced in this case from 6.3 to 1.4 dnd at 250 Hz, and errors for 500 to 8 kHz is well below just one noticeable difference. And we were able to also find the resonance frequency of a back wall panel with slits. So thank you for taking your time to watch this small video on the genetic material optimizer in ODEON. We hope to soon come with a video which shows how you make practical use of this algorithm in ODEON. Thank you.